This generation does not intend to founder in the backwash of the coming age of space. We mean to be a part of it. We mean to lead it.
In Godspeed, John Glenn.
Good Lord, ride always.
As our knowledge of this universe in which we live increases, may God grant us the wisdom and guidance to use it wisely.
The European Space Agency is working to take humans beyond low Earth orbit and deeper into the cosmos. Our next destination on this journey is the moon.
Time to go.
Orion is NASA's next generation spacecraft.
Stay cool.
This is a Thor News presentation.
Is that a video message?
I'm gonna have to science the shit out of this.
Hit the button, baby. Thor News presents.
Well, what do you know? 1 week from the day that I went to a NASA press event, they're announcing that they're going to join forces with the European Space Agency for a historic 2021 manned Orion mission on the moon. The first time humans have left low orbit since 1972. And if you're eagerly awaiting that full video, full commentary, be patient, because I still don't even know how to put those emotions into words that I can convey to you. But one thing I was mildly, extremely disappointed about was it didn't seem like anyone there was ready to pivot to the moon or Venus anytime soon. But apparently I was wrong. The first Orion mission will be uncrewed. There you go. Wait, what? Oh, yeah. See, I'm a big fan of human space exploration. I don't get a boner for robots. Yet, because most of them look like freaking robots, man. So I was trying to joke and shit, and it didn't work. Anyway, an uncrewed mission is expected to launch in 2018. Oh yeah, but the manned mission is set for launch in NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida as early as 2021, asterisk. Will include up to 4 astronauts and be the first time humans have left low orbit since 1972. What you guys should do, man, is like sell lottery tickets to this thing. And so, and if you get picked, you do on the capsule. And hey, if they aren't shape enough, and so they have major physical damage, it would be their own fault. Yeah, I gotta be in shape in my friggin' capsule. Anyway, ESA and Airbus have now agreed with NASA to build a module for the manned mission. You know what I was thinking when I was at NASA? Thinking, that's what I liked with the shuttle, because it was both a capsule and a rocket. And now we just have a capsule and rocket. Mankind has taken a major step towards leaving the orbit of Earth first time since 1972. The European Space Agency says it will contribute key components for a future NASA mission to take humans around the moon in the next 4 years. Think about how cool would it be if they just had, like, luxury liners, you could drink margaritas and circle Earth or circle the moon and stuff. I don't know. Sometimes I think they don't want to get people excited about space. The European Space Agency says it will contribute key components for a future NASA mission to take humans around the moon for the next few years. Astronauts haven't gone beyond a low Earth orbit since 1972, when NASA ended its Apollo program. The mission will use NASA's Orion capsule carried to four astronauts around the moon. First time humans have left the orbit since 1972. The mission is set for launch for NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, USA, as early as 2021, including up to four astronauts. You know, it's weird as when I was at NASA, I did ask a lot of questions. I wasn't a jerk. I wasn't there to throw anybody in the bus. One thing I did ask was, has anybody ever had sex in the International Space Station? And they thought it was a weird question. And it's quite a time that I think, you know, science really needs me. Sometimes y'all don't think right. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, we plan to go to Mars and populate Mars, right? Like, if you can't have kids in outer space, then you can't really colonize shit, man. So you gotta find out if you can have kids. I don't know, can sperm even function in zero G? Yeah. Anyway, it wasn't a weird question. Yeah, I didn't think, but everybody else did. Anyway, the European Space Agency and an astronaut company, Airbus, have already delivered a propulsion and supply module for the unmanned flight of NASA's new Orion spacecraft next year. The agency said today that it and Airbus have now agreed with NASA to build a module for the second manned mission that will fly on the moon as early as 2021. The service module provides propulsion, electrical power, water, and thermal control. Thermal control! As well as maintaining the oxygen and nitrogen atmosphere for the crew. The mission is set to launch for NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, USA, as early as 2021. What do you guys like? Getting paid by the word? What is this like? Third grade trying to pad your paper? You've said that it sounds like five times now. You know? Okay. What am I supposed to act surprised the quality of journalism has gone down since the advent of the smartphone and Wikipedia? Crew size and composition will be determined closer to launch. The mission will see Orion follow three progressively elongated orbits to reach past the moon and return to Earth faster than any manned spacecraft has re-entered our atmosphere before. I'll mention I'm a big fan of human space exploration. I like to return to it. The ESA's director of human space flight, Dave Parker, explained the mission when it was first revealed last year, saying we're excited to be a part of the historic mission and appreciate NASA's trust in us to help extend humanity's exploration farther afield in our solar system. The first Orion service module will be launched in 2018 on NASA's new space launch system. Weird, I got to meet one of the engineers for the SLS. I'll tell you about that later in our really badass awesome video. The month-long mission will be unmanned. Aww. We'll orbit the moon before returning to Earth, testing the spacecraft and the rocket before carrying astronauts. The European Service Module is designed, built, and assembled by a team of companies from 11 countries led by Airbus Space and Defense, based on proven technology from ESA's automated transfer vehicle that flew to the International Space Station 5 times with blast. How this historic manned mission will work. The mission plan for the flight is built around a profile called the multi-translunar injection. Sounds like something that will get you high. And technically it is. While multiple departure burns. Ooh. That's what she said. And includes a free return trajectory from the moon. Well, I don't know if it's free, man. You know, is anything involved in government ever free? Basically, the spacecraft will circle our planet twice while periodically firing its engines to build up enough speed to push it towards the moon before looping back to Earth. After launch, the spacecraft in upper stages, the rocket will first orbit Earth twice to ensure its systems are working normally and nominally. Orion will reach a circular orbit at an altitude of 100 nautical miles and last 90 minutes. The move or burn to get the spacecraft into specific orbit around a planet or other body in space is called orbital insertion. Following the first orbit, the rocket's powerful exploration upper stage EOS and 4RL10 engines will perform an orbital raise, which will place Orion into a highly elliptical orbit around our planet. There you go, there's the mission profile for our first crewed flight of Orion. Exciting stuff. You can count all the numbers yourself. If you can count to 9. If you can't count to 9, you should probably stop watching Thor News and go back to second grade. This is called the partial translunar injection. Didn't we talk about it? You guys should repeat all the same information. For perspective, the International Space Station orbits Earth from about 250 miles above. That's true, it's like 50 miles to 200 miles and it bobs up and down. The second larger orbit will take approximately 24 hours with Orion flying in an ellipse between 500 and 900 nautical miles above Earth. Once the integrated vehicle completes its two orbits, will separate my
any payloads
selected and mounted inside the rocket's universal stage adapter
will be released.
Payloads will then fly on their own to conduct their unique missions. After the EU's operation, the crew do unique tests of Orion's critical systems. They will gather and evaluate engineering data from their day-long orbit before using Orion's service module to complete a second and final propulsion move called the TLI burn, we know. The second burn put Orion on a path towards the moon and will conclude the MTI portion of the mission. The mission and the collaboration of the end. And I know you said that. I'm done with this. I don't need you guys to tell me anymore. You can keep reading the same shit. Subjects in simulation are fitted with the advanced crew escape suits.
Escape suits?
What?
A rocket?
Oh, I'm reading the article for you. Interesting enough. Nope. In November, NASA and the U.S. Navy revealed that space pirates will let them do anything interesting. Wait a second. That's not what it says. In November, NASA and the U.S. Navy revealed the success of recent testing, which amphibious transport dock USS San Diego recovered capsule from what? Am I reading? Why am I getting mad? Maybe it's the pressure on my brain. Let's see, yeah, this article more filler. Did you copy and paste that, bro? Space launch system. Okay, cool. Alright, peace out. God bless you. Sorry about this. Or not. Whatever.